Hey there, this is Floor from Nightwish, and you are colliding with Yell Magazine. Horns up!
So your wardrobe is usually pretty amazing. Do you design it yourself, or and then how do you conceptualize what you're going to wear?
I have a lot of ideas, but need the creative input of a good designer. So some of my outfits have been made by a very talented lady in the Netherlands, and another two ladies in Finland. And so indeed I have a very clear idea. It should be a dress, or it should be a leather outfit, and it should have this and this colors, and it has to have this look. Like, it's, you know, I always try to find the balance between feminine and rock, which is sometimes almost a contradiction. So to walk the balance there, and to play with not only black, you know, it's very challenging. But then it's great to come with a certain concept and talk it over with people who can visualize whatever, you know, bits and pieces of thoughts I have in my head.
Okay. And then when you come up with those visions, are they based on the album at the time, or the tour at the time, or?
I try to have themes of this in there. Yeah.
The Elan
mm-hmm.
video, it's has a beautiful concept, and it ties in well with the theme of the album. Was that a band conceptualization for the video, or was it the director?
A combination, actually. It's mainly Duomas, the songwriter, who has a very clear idea of the story and the energy. And then it's the director who comes with ideas, and I think it was also his idea to have these old Finnish actors. So within Finland they're very famous, so okay. Everybody in Finland knows who these people are. So it was very special to get these people, all of them wanted to cooperate with this, and to see them, you know, lift and have their life, more enjoyed and live your life with great elan, as so. There's a very nice cooperation between ideas from him and the director, and within the process the band comes in and start to think along, and the ideas for the clothing and styling was my idea for myself, because I wanted to create a difference between the band me and the person in the video, you know, not really acting, still myself, but I had a very 50s look.
Yes.
To go with the old look of the place I was in, mm-hmm. And stuff like that. So yeah, it's definitely possible for everybody to give some creative input.
It's almost like the 50s version of you was like an older person's recollection of a great past.
Yeah. Well, that's exactly what we try to set in these old worn places with people, old and worn, and to lift that out and bring it back to life.
Yeah.
And yeah, that was the idea.
Okay. Yeah, we all were young once.
Yeah.
The growing interest in your subgenre of music, the operatic type of vocals over heavy metal, was it less intimidating for you to take the lead with Nightwish?
I never thought of it like that. I mean, I've been in metal bands since I was 17, mm-hmm. in a time just like when Nightwish started, where this was new. Mm-hmm. And it evolved into not per se just operatic voices. I mean, I use my operatic voice maybe a tenth of the time I'm singing. Mm-hmm. So that also kind of grew into a more varied type of singing. Which I personally find very nice to do, to play around with it and not stick to one sound. Also because the music, Nightwish's music, really challenged me to use different kinds of vocals. So that I would think of as more challenging step in like that. And of course I had big shoes to fill, so that was more it. But the whole genre, or subgenre as you call it, indeed has been more stable, more positioned throughout the years, and more in Europe perhaps than it's over here, but it's also growing over here, so that's a very nice sign, good one.
Yes, I love it. It's I love the, I guess it's a juxtaposition, a contrast to the soft femininity with the heavy stuff. The heavy. And then I also love the folk elements too, the traditional elements, those are great too.
Nightwish brings out a lot there, yeah.
Who among your peers, female vocalists, do you look to for inspiration?
I really always loved Skin from Skunk Anansie.
Okay.
I thought it was like, I like rock voices.
Okay.
Funny enough, I'm not too big on the whole opera stuff.
Okay.
I like it in metal, but only a bit. Okay. So for me, she's a powerhouse vocalist. And I always loved Anneke van Giersbergen. She was a singer of The Gathering, Dutch band, and one of the founders of this genre within the Netherlands. And also cross borders often enough, but for me, when I heard her sing, that was one of those moments in life, actually, where I thought, wow, that kind of vocals, not operatic, on metal, awesome.
Okay. What do you think of like the death growls, like, formerly Angela Gassau of Arch Enemy.
Yeah, or your own Alyssa. She's from here.
We were just talking about
her. Yeah, I think that's fantastic.
Yeah.
I remember, because I know the band for years, and talking with her, Angela is my physical opposite, because I'm a tall lady. She's just a tiny blonde lady. And I do, whoa, and she just, how on earth do you do it? I never got it. But I'm a bit of a vocal nerd. I love the techniques, and they weren't really around when I studied yet. But I've always stayed curious for new developments within the vocal methods. And then there came a method that really nicely described what you're doing and some good exercises. So I started to try and found how you do it. So okay. I'm also growling on this Endless Forms Most Beautiful album, because I find it very intriguing, especially there's something about a woman doing it.
Yeah.
I mean, of course, we are built differently, so we can never really get that low, even though I must say I've heard Alyssa, because they were, Arch Enemy was touring with us in Europe every day. She can do some amazing stuff, and I have big respect for that.
Yeah. You said you're a vocal nerd. I know you taught vocal lessons.
Yeah,
and
used to,
I'm pretty sure Angela did that as well. Did you swap teaching tips or anything?
No, not like that. No.
Nothing extremely nerdy?
I didn't even
know
that she was teaching, to be honest. No.
Well, she has a workshop on YouTube.
Okay,
and
awesome.
She's in front of an audience. So
all right, cool.
Yeah, okay. One Nightwish album under your belt. Are you more confident going forward with another album?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
I mean, everything you do for the first time is more exciting. You find, you have to find your way of working. Fortunately, everything we've been doing together has been very smooth. We're all experienced, fortunately, so it wasn't the first time to make an album, but to do it together, it was. So I can imagine for next time, it will be even easier as it was now. But also in this process, it was very, very natural.
Is there an album in the works, or?
No. I mean, this album has been out not even a year.
Right.
We've been touring nonstop.
Almost a year.
Huh?
Almost a year, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. Yeah. And we're February, so end of March it came out. Yeah. So no new stuff yet.
That's okay. And last year you did some live recordings for a DVD. Is that out yet, or is there an expected release date? I saw the tour version of the album. It does have
that has
DVD
live material.
Is that
on
what it?
It
is, or
with, partially, yes.
Okay.
So that we have, and we have been collecting material on several shows from several places in the world. Vancouver is in there, Mexico's in there. We did our first stadium show in Finland. That's going to be in there. We played Wembley Arena in London, which is prestigious, tongue-breaking, prestigious venue to play.
Yeah.
So we've, but all very different from each other. You know, stadium versus a relatively small venue in Vancouver. Crazy Mexicans in that kind of setting,
yeah.
And then Wembley Arena. Or so we have something special coming up, and the only luxury problem we have is to choose from all that stuff what's going to be on there. But there's going to be something special coming for fans. Yeah.
Yes, it's great for the fans to like, I was there, or that's my town.
or what we also could imagine, you know, if you've been to a show here, to get a glimpse of what it's like in Europe, or you know what it's like in Mexico, because every country, every continent comes with different audiences. It comes with different possibilities. We can't bring as big as a production here as we can in Europe. So it shows different atmospheres. It's maybe also nice to see.
Yeah, as you said, Tuamas.
Yeah, Tuamas. Yeah.
Okay, I know he's the principal songwriter.
Yes.
Is it and lyricist as well? Yes. Is it difficult for you to connect to someone else's lyrics?
Well, it was the first time that I was going to do this. I mean, since early after Forever Days, where also the guitar player at the time wrote lyrics. I remember back then I found it challenging to get the rhythm right in a vocal melody, because I would still write the melodies, but with an existing lyric and fit it in them. It was always a bit of a challenge. Tuomas writes everything. But what I got was a piano playing the melody and the lyrics. And then you go and puzzle, and we talked it over, and I was, not something I am used to, but it worked so smoothly, so easily, because he writes really, really well. And we took our time to really rehearse everything through with the whole band, so you can really feel if something works or not, and with everybody involved, and also even backing vocals started to occur really fast, thinking along with Marco. That's also why he sings way more backings than he did before. Some comments have been made previously that it seems that he sang less on this album. He does in lead, he has less parts, but background or the harmonies we made together, it's much more. That's also because of this process and because of the natural feel of everything. So it, instead of being quite challenging, it became a very easy thing to do, and you can really notice a well-written song just explains itself.
For the final question, it might be kind of heavy, but what keeps you up at night?
Oh, cheese and red wine.
Okay, it's not heavy at all.
Yeah, that would keep me out of bed anyway, or I would get back out of bed. But you know, on a more serious level, some of the things that are happening right now, and the refugees in Europe, people fleeing from Syria, Afghanistan, all those countries where things are just going so terribly wrong, and the whole world falling over it with no proper solution. Things going wrong in countries where the refugees actually come to, things that they do to the locals, doesn't make things easier, and there's so much tension all around that would keep me up.
Yeah. I suppose as a touring band, you get a pretty good perspective.
Well, yes, and I mean we were on tour when the attack in Paris happened, a shooting in a venue where people were killed during a live concert.
Right at
Eagles of Death Metal. Yeah, a lot of mainly actually American bands canceled tours. People were afraid to come to venues, of course. Threats all over Europe spread like a wildfire. People got afraid, which was exactly where they were hoping for, of course, and exactly what we didn't want to, give in to.
Right.
But of course, when you climb on stage the next day after something like that, it's very real. It's very in your face.
Yeah.
Security everywhere, bomb dogs, going through the venue twice a day, every day. It's very intimidating, and that I really that made an impression on all of us. But also, really say we are not going to be intimidated by a small group of people, because it's still
a small
group of extremists who apparently are so unorganized they can't do anything bigger than this. I'm happy for that.
Yes.
But it's also not bigger than that. Let us not get too crazy about this. And. But still, of course, yes, it's in your daily life then all of a sudden. And I hope these things will get easier again, that people find a little bigger peace in their heart to be a bit more open-minded and not believe everything the media and the politicians are telling us, because we are just getting more and more afraid by things that are being pulled out of perspective, really.
Yeah.
So, it's a... it's a weird moment in life, but I really hope for everybody that things will become a bit easier.